People who actually care remotely about the royal family. Why? 50s when she was crowned and 90s with Diana. I've got 20 quid on Prince Philip being alive. Edit, alright, some background, my friend is convinced he died but they are keeping him on ice till the coronavirus does one so they can have a right big funeral for the cunt. I don't know how the bet ends, I'll be honest. I see them as a symbol of Britain and the wider Commonwealth, even those who don't see the Queen as their head of state. I watched a doc on the royal family and they do a hell of a lot of work, like visits or giving patronage to charities. Look what Lady Di did for AIDS HIV in the UK. Plus they bring a lot of revenue to the UK in terms of tourism, and the majority of their costs are covered by their own lands that generate wealth. Could argue this is more classiest than needed, but they have a lot of people in employment. They also bring great prestige to the UK, granted isn't as prominent than it was, but having a country seen more positive than negative in the world's eyes is a good thing, imho. British have the royal family. Americans have the Kardashians. Celebrity worship is a hobby for some people. If one of them dies, we get an extra bank holiday. Which royal family? The Danish? Dutch? Norwegian? British? Belgian? I don't really care for the royal family, but I do appreciate the institution, the monarchy. Even with a largely ceremonial role, the king is a stabilizing factor, because he doesn't need to care about being re-elected. Even with a ceremonial president, like in Germany, there's always the party discussion. People who care about people who care about the royal family, why? On balance, I don't believe we should have a royal family, but I don't think it is quite as cut and dry as it appears. Stephen Fry has some good points on this. The value of having a figurehead that represents tradition, pomp and ceremony and history that is separate from an elected official cannot be overlooked. When they are the same person, e.g. a president, you lose something. The value in having the Prime Minister meet with this figure every week to explain themselves. Imagine if Trump had to do that to old Uncle Sam every week. It has a tempering effect on the political winds that can sway the country when it flips from left to right. The modern obsession with destroying institutions can be more damaging than those institutions are in the first place. He describes it like removing the hedgerows in a field, leaving them exposed to be eroded by wind. I haven't yet seen anyone mention the Crown Estate. George III was struggling to maintain his land, there's a lot of it. So he asked the government for a salary in exchange for giving all the profits from the land to the country as long as he didn't have to manage it himself. Every monarch since has done that too. So besides the fact they do nothing is wrong, the Queen alone is nearing 100 and still does a lot of charitable work, etc. But the land that belongs to her brings in hundreds of millions of pounds a year, which she could technically keep for herself. I don't care about them as people, but more what they, or more specifically, the Queen represents. As a head of state and representative of a nation, the Queen is unlike other heads of state in that she is incorruptible. She is completely apolitical, can't be bribed, doesn't have to gain favor to win office and then deliver on favors once she's in office, and doesn't owe anything to anyone and so can't be manipulated financially. Never have I appreciated this as much since Donald Trump came to power in the US. Which royal family? The entire concept of royal is interesting historically slash politically, but as far as royals being celebrities, I value them about as much as any other celebrity, very, very little. You'll have to be specific. Which royal family? Which royal family? There are plenty. The fact that someone asks about the royal family and almost everyone answers referring to the British and not other royal family says a lot about their popularity. Because they represent our country to the world and provide a good deal of stability. The monarchy is one of Britain's best assets. I grew up incredibly close to my nana and papa. My nana's parents are British and Welsh, my papa is a born and bred Scot. Every year, they used to go to the UK to visit my papa's family that was still there. Growing up, their stories about their trips there and my extended family piqued my interest in the culture overseas, and my nana was a total royal enthusiast. She was so well-mannered and poised, if someone had said she were related to the Queen, I would have believed them. We loved the pomp and pageantry, in particular the music. The sound of a booming pipe organ and the choir out of Westminster Abbey was their favorite thing about it, and they instilled the same love in me. I still get chills whenever I hear it. For me, the royals bring back happy memories of time with my grandparents. They keep me connected to the memory of my nana. I care about the royal family of my country because they do great work. They are great diplomats and representatives for the country, and they can gather the people in a crisis. They are an asset to our country. Edit, also all the tourists they attract boosts the economy. I just think they're neat. I like to see people happy. I'm happy William and Harry got to choose someone they love. I've got a tenor on Charles dying before his mum. I'm pro-royal but almost completely for the economic benefits that it brings to tourism. I think we should be reducing the amount of funding they receive, especially those that are so far from the throne that no one even knows them. I like the idea of having a consistent figurehead as well, one that also isn't a crazy dictator, although technically she could take control, I believe. I think it's helped a lot of international relations and means the relationship is less likely to turn sour because of the current government, like the US has done these past few years with many of its allies. But I don't care about them as people particularly. I'm sure they're nice enough, but I've never done the whole following celebs thing anyway. I've never understood the obsession of getting involved in the life of someone that doesn't even know you exist. TL, Doctor, good for tourism and stability, bad for some parts being a drain on taxpayer money and to some extent democracy. The Queen looks a lot like my grandmother. I like to think that my grandma was sick of living a double life, faked her death, and now is enjoying being queen full time. Of course, my grandmother lived in southeastern Idaho and was 6 feet tall, so there are some flaws in my theory, but I do find the queen endearing because of the resemblance. The monarchy cost the British taxpayer £30.6 million a year. The crown estates bring in about £230 million a year, so it more than pays for itself. I love history, and the British history of the monarchy is very much like Game of Thrones. It has everything. I don't care per se, but I would never want it abolished. I just find it funny we managed to sneak an American into it, if only for a bit. People who actually care remotely about the Kardashians. Why? 1. British history is interesting. 2. Thinking about it is a good way to distract myself when my life isn't going so well. 3. It makes my family look functional by comparison. I don't know, I just really like the Queen. She is so cute, I want her to be my grandma. I mean, I don't give a shit about them either, but chances are you and I also give a shit about something else dumb as fuck. I mean, we're on Reddit. We are all probably obsessed with some dumbass anime or game or something. No use acting all smug and pretending to be better than the normies who read celebrity gossip. You are just as worthless as everyone else. Harry owes me a pint. I was at a lock-in with him near Highgrove when he bought a bottle of champagne and sat down to hit on the girl I was dating. By way of apology, he said he'd get me a pint and never did. With the-